that was the music of SPK. Before that, Dead Kennedys with Kinky Sex Makes the World Go Round. We also heard Golden Palominos and Phil Manzanera. But something else to listen to right now, a tape brought to us by Genesis. Please tell me how to pronounce your last name.
P-Orridge Decadant.
Okay, and he is here in the studio.
The P stands for pervert and piercing.
Thank you. And your friend here is John.
John Doe Gosling Joan of Arc.
And tell us about this tape we're listening to right now.
Well, I can't hear it, but I'm sure it's good fun.
I can give you some headphones, I
suppose. Can you give me headphones? I'd like to hear it, because it always makes me feel better.
Right now, there's just a woman giggling.
No, it's actually Jim Jones.
Not giggling, the high voice?
That's Jim Jones. Laughing as everyone dies.
Ah.
You all remember Jim Jones. You all remember Jim Jones, don't ya?
Can you hear it now?
No, I can't, but it doesn't matter. I know what it sounds like.
Okay.
I believe you. As long as everyone out there has not gone to sleep, they'll be able to stay awake and listen to him.
Okay, and the reason we have you in the studio is...
Because you like kinky sex. You just played some.
We did. And we would like to see a performance on Easter Sunday.
Yes.
It is
our favorite insult.
To...
Jehovah, Jesus, Jim Jones, Jesus Christ, God Almighty God.
And Janet Callahan, the Catholic.
And Rose... and Rose Kennedy, the dwarf.
You are in Massachusetts, you know this is Kennedy country.
I did realize it was Kennedy country.
And they're all listening.
I hope so, even the crippled one.
Aww. And the phone is ringing, the phone ins are starting already.
Groovy, groovy.
So, why don't I just plug them in? They will have to share the phone with the tape.
Don't forget to stretch it.
Stretch what?
I'm getting the hang of it now, Sam.
WZBC. Hello. They're not going on. I think they hung up.
Oh, chickens.
Okay, well, we'll let the tape play. Let's get the...
Should we tell everybody what we're here for?
Facts down, yes.
I think we ought to before they all go away. Or bomb the place. Which should we do first?
They won't do that, but there's one out there who's going to come and slit our sweaters and have us pissing out of a tube on ComEv. Is that the words? There's a person who occasionally phones us and threatens us, and he knows we like it, so he keeps doing it. And he will like this tape too, I'm sure. And the record. The record we're going to play is the Final Hours.
Yeah, it's a new limited edition LP we've just released for the Easter weekend. It's called The Last Supper.
And who's accredited to the artist?
The artist is the Reverend Jim Jones. The artist is the World Satanic Network Service.
Mm-hmm.
And there are 912 copies pressed as a picture disc, one for each dead body at Jonestown, Guyana.
Oh.
Each one numbered in gold. Dead body number one. Dead body number two. And dead body number three, etc.
So, what will it be filed under at the record store?
Filed under perversion.
Jones, no.
Filed under religious music, I would imagine.
That's it. And the fact is, the show is on Easter Sunday at the Longwood Theater.
Longwood Theater, Massachusetts College of Art, or School of Art.
School
College.
Of Art.
364 Brookline, Longwood T Station.
Right over there by the hospital.
Come out the station, turn left past the posh apartments.
And the hospitals are right there if you need them after the show.
Yes, the children's hospital for the young'uns.
And the show begins at 8 o'clock?
No.
It's started already. It's going on in Iceland
now. It begins at 10 o'clock on Sunday. You're getting it. She's getting good at this, isn't she? She's definitely good at this. It begins at 10 o'clock on Sunday.
But it began in Iceland how many hours ago?
It began at 2 p.m. Iceland time, but that was 9 p.m. 8 o'clock. Well, 8 o'clock this morning here. And so, with some help from our friends in Boston, we began a ritual anti-Christian invocation to raise demons and destroy angels, mm-hmm. and generally shrink the willy of Jesus. Keep him earthbound, we say. Don't let him get back up there each year.
And it's 1 o'clock a.m. This is Boston College Radio, WZBC Newton. You know Boston College, a good Catholic school. Father Monin, I presume, is listening.
Catholic.
So,
you've heard of O'Hanessy?
Oh, yes.
O'Callaghan? O'Lick.
Oh.
Come on.
Okay. You put the apostrophes in Catholic and it. I get it. What is the cat for then?
That's the name of the girl. She's 12 years old. She lives in Stilson Avenue. Her name is
Kath,
and she's a very naughty girl.
Let's play the record. All I hear is Jim Jones. He's still giggling.
I don't blame him.
Tedious after a while. Of course, I'm sure the show wasn't tedious when he was doing it. This is the other record, the picture disc.
This is the world premiere of the picture disc.
The world premiere?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
The only picture disc in the world where you can hear 912 people are really dying.
I'm just talking about Jim Jones. People can stop it and stop it and stop it. You have your eyes gone.
No more. We're trying. If everybody will relax. The best thing you do is relax and you'll have no problem. You'll have no problem with the thing if you just relax. It's taken a great deal because of Jim Jones. And the way the children are laying there now, I'd rather see them laid like that than to see them have to die like the Jews did, which was pitiful anyhow. And I'd just like to thank God for giving us life and also death. And I appreciate the fact the way our children are going. Because, like Brad said, when they come in, what they're going to do to our children, they're going to massacre our children. And also the ones that they take captive, they're going to just let them grow up and be dummies like they want them to be. And not grow up to be officials like the one and only Jim Jones. So I'd like to thank God for our opportunity to let Jonestown be not what it could be, but what Jonestown is. Thank you, Dad.
It's not to be feared. It is not to be feared. It's a friend. It's a friend. Sitting there, show your love for one another. Let's get gone. We have nothing we can do. We can't separate ourselves from our own people. For 20 years laying in some old rotten nursing home. All these anguish years. They took us and put us in chains, and that's nothing. There's no comparison to that, to this. They robbed us of our land, and they've taken us and driven us, and we tried to find ourselves. We tried to find a new beginning, but it's too late. You can't separate yourself from your brother and your sister. No way I'm going to do it. I refuse. I don't know who fired the shot. I don't know who killed the congressman. But as far as I'm concerned, I killed him. You understand what I'm saying? I killed him. He had no business coming. I told him not to come.
Okay, we're back on. Jen, what was happening there exactly, in case it wasn't obvious by the screams?
I think there were a few reluctant suicides at Jonestown from the sound of it.
They weren't ready to meet their maker?
I don't think they were sure who the maker was.
Who's this maker on the tape we hear now? I hear...
This is Alistair Crowley, who died in 1947. And he's singing the Enochian calls to summon up satanic demons. So the Enochian calls were originally evolved by John Dee in the time of Queen Elizabeth I. He was one of the magical advisors to the Queen of England then. And he used to write his magical books in a language called Enochian, which he said was the speech of the angels.
Okay, and... do any of these pieces come into your performance you do? Do you use any of the sounds?
Well, the performance on Sunday will not be a musical performance in the sense that there will be no instruments whatsoever. Everything will be pre-recorded video, film, and audio tape, because it is actually an alternative television program, an Easter Sunday television program at that. And the basic intention is to make the audience submissive.
Yes, go on.
They can either leave or they can stay.
They can't leave.
And yes, they can leave. They can either leave or they can stay and be completely submissive and then thereby go through an experience not to be repeated.
And this is a world premiere too.
It is indeed, it is indeed.
Designed especially for the event works?
That's right. It's something we've always wanted to do because we wanted to get away from the concept of entertainment and start to deal with something much more intimate and total, something which dealt with the conscious and the subconscious simultaneously.
So the persons in the room with you are not necessarily audience?
No, they're not. It's
slaves.
In fact, in a sense, this is a good place to talk about it. It's more like a Catholic communion service, really. There'll be the priests guiding people through the path to enlightenment, and then there will be the communion with the audio spirit, and then they will see the demons, devils, angels and spirits, and maybe even Jesus and Virgin Mary floating around there somewhere.
Floating around there somewhere?
Well, there, is it?
What is there?
There is a very strange sensation sometimes.
Wonderful.
We tend to deal with the subject of control and conditioning.
And how do the Iceland cohorts come into this?
Well, what they were doing in Iceland today involved parts of what we're going to be doing on Sunday, and then on Sunday we'll be incorporating parts of what they've done in our event.
And it's all part of an ongoing ritual you have for the Holy Weekend?
Well, yeah, this is a specially designed ritual for the Holy Weekend, an unholy ritual. And it's research, basically. We want to find out what happens. Whether we're struck down and what effect it has on people's perception.
So will you hand out questionnaires afterward?
No, we don't need
the bodies.
I think their bodies will tell them
body
that.
Body count?
Maybe another body count. It's a metabolic process. But just in case everybody listening isn't sure whether we do or do not ever do anything musical, I think you should play them the pretty one just to keep them at ease, don't you?
Yes, this is a regular song by P-TV.
I'll explain why it's irregular afterwards.
And we'll just play it.
When all the numbers swim together and all the shadows settle, windows forced open shut again, like drag and a petal, my eyes burn and flows rush and fill them. And in the morning to the night, falling in love with the light, it is so clear I feel like the fear of the when all the fingers sound retreat, his own skin starts to shrivel, dreams may feel become less sweet, rocket on the metal, my sex turns on the floor, flesh will spill away. But in the morning, after the night, I fall in love with the night, it is so pure I cannot hide, and the pain will seek all the way. Thank you.
somebody. Who's at the microphone? Tell us about the song.
That song? I don't know anything about it. You were talking to Jen about it, really. Yeah. So I wasn't around when that was made.
Okay. Well, Jen's over on the other side of the room now.
Ask me something else.
Okay, what is your involvement in this?
This event coming up.
You are part of the...
I'm just going to be putting tapes on, basically. It's going to be very boring on Sunday night. Just going to be sticking tapes in the cassette machine and mixing them up and down. It's going to be a very boring evening.
Oh, that's your job.
Yeah.
Have you been doing this long?
Well, sticking tapes in cassette decks.
Yes.
Yeah.
You keep doing this? Why?
Yeah?
It's boring. We like being bored.
Yeah, I like being bored.
I think...
Everyone else is going to be bored, too.
So they shouldn't come.
No, I wouldn't advise it. I shouldn't.
They know that already.
Others.
Wow. So tell us about the record we just played.
Jen, tell them.
Everyone's on the edge of their seat saying, what was that pretty song? That couldn't have been Psychic TV, you know.
Yeah.
I'm just mimicking the audience.
The last song was recorded in a church in England, in fact. And the music was played primarily by Burn Again Christians.
Mm-hmm.
The lyric, however...
Burn Again Christians.
The lyric, however... They were very nice people, I must be fair. They were all right. Especially Jessica, who played the oboe. What they didn't know was that we were going to put a lyric on afterwards, which, although it's called the Orchids, is in fact a medical term for testicles. And an orchidectomy is a castration.
Mm-hmm.
And when it talks about the centre being pierced by steel, that is quite literal in that everyone in Psychic TV has a steel ring through their penis or clitoris. So it's actually about sexual piercings.
Right. I saw those in the videos in New York.
So you know exactly what I'm talking about.
Yes, yes.
We used to be much more aggressive in the old days. Now what we like to do is be seductive and actually still have a distasteful side.
What is the difference?
Well, if you're aggressive, you make a lot of noise and yell, a bit like SPK used to do. And if you're seductive, you're a bit more subtle. You make things appear to be very nice and acceptable and hummable, but when people find out what they're actually humming, it's something that they would normally not deal with.
By, yes.
Or, and it appeals to us more. It's more mischievous and it's also more difficult and therefore it's more satisfying to do. And it's through that work that we've started working more with tape, video and film to do the same thing, to initially seduce people into the idea of comfortable television and then by the end of the hour leave them wondering whether it was in fact comfortable television or it was something much more potent and powerful. And there won't be a point where they could say their opinion or their perception has actually changed. But what they felt at the very beginning of the hour and what they feel at the very end will be radically different.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that whole process of change and the way that different media, whether they're records or books or the television, work, is a very important area to study. It's related completely to the behavioural structure of people's relationships and their psyche. And our private concern is different ways to reach the unconscious, the dream consciousness, and to express that. So obviously the paths to it are things that we investigate. And the organization of the material is far more important than the end product. We use the same organizational technique to make a pretty song, like the Orchids, as we would use to do something which was abrasive and not pleasant to listen to. We use exactly the same techniques, but the end result can be radically different.
And so, again, the emphasis to the listeners out there, if you're going for a performance, this is not a performance, this is a research.
Construction.
Yeah, so
it's an event.
We shall be the guinea pigs.
You should be, yeah, very much guinea pigs. But we shall also be guinea pigs.
because it's not been done before, and we want to find out what happens to us too. We're equally as curious, and we do want to make it dense and vivid enough for it to be exciting, even if not easy to classify.
I like it. And again, if you just tuned in, it's been a while. We are speaking with Genesis of Psychic TV, who is holding a scientific study this Sunday, Easter Sunday, at 10 o'clock p.m.
10 o'clock on Sunday. It's
evening, yes.
$8 to get in regular and $5 if you're a student, and tickets are available tomorrow at Hubba Hubba and Innersleeve Records.
And you can always call us here later for those, the location of those places or other information.
And the main thing we wanted to stress was that, and why John was saying what he was, is that we didn't come to do a rock and roll thing, mm-hmm. which is what people might expect. We didn't come to perform in the form or with the look of a music group.
Mm-hmm.
But that's not to say that what we're doing isn't serious. In fact, in a sense, it's more exactly what we're trying to do than we've done before. In fact, it's us revealing more of our private selves than we have before. So in that sense, it's more intimate.
And so I don't think it would make sense to applaud such things. Well,
I would imagine most people would find that illogical at the end.
Yeah.
Of
yeah.
But I think it's the kind of event that will begin to sink in slowly. We'll start to have a reverberation slowly, and perhaps in a month's time it'll be the kind of thing that they'll be glad to say, I was there, why weren't you there? And they'll try and describe it to someone else and find it impossible to describe except in physical terms, and people will wonder what the hell it was and won't ever be able to appreciate it.
It won't sound like much if you just describe it.
And I think that it's about time that when you go somewhere and you pay to go somewhere, it's something you could not experience anywhere else. You couldn't play it on a record, you couldn't watch it on a normal TV, you couldn't buy it anywhere. You have to go there with your body in order to experience it. And I think that's something that's sadly lacking a lot of the time.
And we also have...
Do you want me to tell them this as well, Sandie?
Do you want to go on and...
No, I was just going to say, it's in reference to the last tune that we played and the mentions of organising, we've brought with us a tape of a new single we're releasing in France in May.
Mm-hmm.
And we thought we might as well play it here as anywhere else. So it's never been played on the radio anywhere in the world before. Perhaps some people will listen to it and say, I'm not surprised, but nevertheless.
If they listen to us, they know we take a lot of chances here and we play other things that no one...
But it's another one in the line of seduction as opposed to aggression. But it does have a twist.
Oh, just the way you speak of these things sounds seductive.
Does it?
Yeah. In the show, too, it sounds like something not to be missed now.
I think sensuality and seduction are interesting areas to deal with, really. So here's a bit more seduction for anyone who's lying in bed.
I have to reach back and plug this in. Thank you.
Oh,
their new song to be released in a month or so?
In May, on the Sordid Sentimental label, which comes from France.
The famous Sordid Sentimental.
With the monster package and loads of philosophical texts that nobody can understand.
Are you going to have the graphics in the book of your own?
No. Oh, one photo of everybody wearing Charles Manson t-shirts, apart from that. No, I like to... He likes to do all the packaging himself. That's why he does them, really. It's an excuse to do the packaging. But I like the way he works. And that song, as everyone probably noticed, was called Roman P, the P standing for Polanski, as opposed to piercing, although it might still stand for pervert as well. And
my other question was about your symbol, the Psychic TV logo.
It's a line with
two crosses on it, the Psychic Cross, which is derived from various
yeah symbols. I mean, we tried to choose a sign which would gradually infiltrate the popular culture and become accepted as something that seemed to always have existed. So we wanted it to have a very familiar feel to it, as if you had seen it before but you weren't sure where. So we quite deliberately designed it with the proportions of 2 and 3 as well, because 23 is part of our
23,
language. The only thing which is almost exactly the same is there is an old alchemical symbol which means very poisonous or dangerous. But in fact, in that, the centre line is slightly longer than the two at the top and bottom, whereas in ours it's slightly shorter. If you take the very bottom off in Japanese, it means F-U-C-K or master. If you take away the bottom line, you get the French cross. And if you take away two lines, you get the Christian cross. Or if you take away the top two lines, you get the Satanic cross, and so on. Or it even looks slightly like a TV aerial as well.
Yes, it does.
And San was explaining another version of it. What was yours? San. San's just over the other side of the studio. Can you remind?
When Christ was crucified, there was two criminals crucified
with him.
And sometimes on the cross there's a small top and a small bottom besides the large one.
To symbolize the two thieves.
Yeah. And instead now these two thieves have been enlarged and Christ has been shrunken.
Well, now the two thieves have been enlarged and Christ has been shrunken. You know, draw your own conclusions. In other words, everyone can keep on interpreting it and giving us new explanations of what it is, and in fact that was the original intention, that it developed its own life, and its only constant is that to people interested in our attitude or philosophy, to them it reminds them of a direction or a system by which to develop, and each time they see it reminds me of that, just the same as any other symbol. All symbols have potence.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and we, one last time, what's this, wrap-up time?
Telephone calls.
Oh yes, we want telephone calls if you want to talk to John or Jen.
And in case anybody didn't hear it before, it's in the Longwood Theatre at the Massachusetts College of Art. Not in the toilet.
Sunday at 10. And our phone number is 552-4686. If you would like to speak with these gentlemen, do call.
English gentlemen.
And
very
this
English.
This is American College Radio, WZBC, in case you forgot. And we're going to go on with the regular program now. This is music from Danielle Dax.
I could tell you a few stories about her.
Right ahead.
They're all obscene, it's not...
Never mind. This is WZBC, now concluding our broadcast day. WZBC Newton. is Boston College Radio. The Federal Communications Commission has allowed us to broadcast at 1,000 watts at our frequency of 90.3 megacycles. The trustees of Boston College hold our license, and our offices and studios are located in McElroy Common on the Boston College campus. WZBC Newton is our official ID. Good evening from the folks of Psychic TV and Caress, who is not with us in person, but she is in audio and in spirit, I think.